Hey everyone, it's Neil Patel here. I'm with Adam from Viewership.
Hey everyone.
We're here for another Q&A Thursday, where whenever you have questions around marketing, business, or anything, you can always leave a comment with your question and we may answer it next Thursday. So please leave your comments with any questions you have. So today, what's the question for this week?
This question is from Ben, and he says, hey Neil, great advice. Just wondering, what are your thoughts on social media strategy for a dull topic? I'm a mortgage broker in the UK, and it'd be great to get some ideas and tips.
If you're in a boring industry, that's okay, I am too. Funny enough, someone hit me up the other week or month, and I think their name was MJ, I don't know their full name. I got on the phone with them, and they're like, oh, we can make you popular on social media. And they showed me a video of someone cooking with Hennessy, and it was awesome, and they were really going viral on Facebook. And I'm like, I can't really do this for my industry. I'm in B2B, I'm dealing with Fortune 1000 companies. If I do too much stuff that's funny or comedic, it's not really gonna generate me more business. Sure, I can generate the views, but that defeats the purpose. What's the point of having millions of views and no revenue? You agree with that?
I totally agreed, yeah.
Yeah, and it's not about a vanity metric such as views. It's all about getting the right audience to you. So let's say you're in an industry like mortgages. Mm-hmm. And his name was Ben?
Ben, yep.
Thank you for asking the question, Ben. Yep. Ben mentioned he was in the UK. I bet you right now, in London, home prices are probably higher than most other places in the world. Ben, you could be creating infographics on things like the top 10 most expensive cities to live in this world. Even if you don't service those regions, because I bet you Paris is gonna be in there, you're probably gonna have some parts like Zurich, or I don't know what other regions, New York, or New York City, San Francisco, Boston, Seattle, you name it, there's gonna be a lot of random regions or cities that are gonna be in there, and that's okay, even if you don't service them. Create an infographic breaking down the most expensive cities to live in. You can break down home prices, cost of food, cost of transportation, if there's any luxury taxes, and then you could even break down in that infographic top 10 cheapest and most affordable places to live. Or you can do a whole new infographic on the best 10 places to live, and you can do a comparison based off of school districts, based off of home prices, crime. And by doing this, then you can end up taking that content and sharing it on the social web, because everyone has to live somewhere. And it'll usually go viral, get a lot of likes, shares, and you'll start getting also backlinks from it. When you're creating infographics, use a plugin, assuming you're on WordPress, WP Embed Code Generator. This will allow people to take your infographic, embed it onto their website, which will allow them to link back to you, which will boost your Google rankings as well. So not only are you getting social media traffic, but you're also now getting Google juice from it as well. If you don't have a social media following, what you should be doing is you go to BuzzSumo, you type in articles or keywords related to the content you just created, click the view shares button, it'll show you all the people who share that article, manually outreach to them. You can say something like, hey Neil, I noticed you shared this article called The 10 Most Affordable Places to Live in the World. I recently created an infographic, which is way more visual, that breaks down the 10 most expensive places to live in the world. Let me know if you want to check it out. And that's it. And in most cases, they'll respond back and telling you, yes, we'll love to see it. You send it to them, they'll share it, they'll be like, oh, thanks. They'll usually share it, and you'll start getting a lot more social media traffic. You can do the same thing with backlinks. I know your question, Ben, was mainly for social media, but if you're already creating the content for social media, might as well get some Google love for it as well.
Of course.
You used to do the same thing. You got a ton of traffic. You started on social media. Mm-hmm. How many views did your main YouTube channel have?
Like 42 million.
42 million.
Yeah.
And how many visits per month did your blog have when you decided that you wanted to get into blogging after your YouTube channel was already popular?
Like only like 1,000
a day? A month?
1,000 a day.
So 30,000. And most of it's coming because of your social media profile, correct?
Exactly, yeah.
And then you started putting in that same content and started leveraging SEO, and what happened to your traffic?
I've now got 7,500 uniques yesterday.
Cool, and how long did it take you to get from 1,000 a day to 7,500?
4 months.
That's right, it's not rocket science, it's
Neil
really
Patel.
Easy.
He's a You're master. Welcome.
And thank you for all the help with video marketing. Okay, so take that content that you have and share it on the web with other people who link to your competitors. A good example of this is you take all the competing pieces, just like that article that you found on BuzzSumo, you go to Ahrefs, A-H-R-E-F-S.com, put in the URL, it'll show you all the people who linked to that article, you hit them all up, and you ask them to also link to your article. Similar type of format. Hey John, I noticed you linked to an article that breaks down the 10 most affordable places to live in the world. I recently created an infographic which is really visual and it showcases the 10 most expensive places in the world to live. Here's the link. Cheers, Neil. Something like that. I know the flow of the email is not perfect, but I'm coming up with it off the top of my head. So if you do something like that, you'll start getting backlinks. You have to send out roughly 100 emails to get around 5 links, and that's okay, it's a quantity game. But you combine that social strategy with the linking strategy, not only do we get more social media traffic, you also get more Google traffic, and it's a win-win. So I hope that helps you crush it on the web, Ben. It's okay if you're in a boring industry.
And just, I should say, just coming from a person who's not in a boring industry, it's actually really hard to put yourself out there because everyone else is not boring. So you can really differentiate yourself, right? If you are in a boring industry and you kind of push the...
That's true.
You know?
And that's why I got into video. I'm like, wait, marketing, a lot of people think it's boring. I'm not talking about the TV campaigns. I'm talking about like the nitty gritty steps and the tactics. But I was like, why not put myself out there, connect with people and really try to help them out.
Absolutely.
So that's it for this week's Q&A Thursday. Thank you guys for watching. If you have any questions about this, leave a comment below. I will answer it. If you want to be in next week's Q&A Thursday, leave your question below and maybe I'll select it. Thank you guys for watching. Best of luck with your business. Make sure you subscribe, like, share. Appreciate all the love you guys are providing me.
Talk to you next Thursday, guys.